Hello friends, in this video we will discuss about polar coordinates and its conversion to Cartesian coordinates. So polar coordinates are represented by a pair of coordinates, that is r and theta. R is the length of a straight line joining origin to the point and theta is the angle made by this line. Suppose there is a point and we have to represent the position of this point in polar coordinates. Here is the origin, its origin. So we draw a line from origin to this point. The length of this line is called as r, and the angle of this line from x-axis is called as theta. So position of this point in polar coordinates would be r comma theta. So in polar coordinates we represent the length of the line and the angle. Let's take some examples. We have to represent these positions on this graph. So first position is 2, 30 degrees. So here first we will draw angle, like this much angle is 30 degrees, and then we draw out 2 centimeters. This position is 2, 30 degrees. So suppose we have to now draw -2, 30 degrees. So 30 is the angle here, but this upward is the positive 2, like 2, 30. So what we do? We go the downward, the same angle. The keep in mind the same angle. We have to go behind in the third coordinate. So here it is -2 length. So this point would be -2, 30 degrees. And suppose we have to draw 3, 120 degrees. So first we will draw angle. We take angle always from the positive x-axis. So first we will go 120 degrees. So this is the angle 120 degrees, and then length is 3. This point would be 3, 120 degrees. Now what's the relation between Cartesian and polar coordinates? So you know, if there is a point here and this is x-axis and that's y-axis, so in Cartesian coordinates we take horizontal distance and then vertical distance. This would be x and this would be y. So its Cartesian coordinate would be x comma y. But in polar coordinates what we take? We draw the line here, and length of this line would be r, and the angle of this line theta from x axis. So r comma theta would be polar coordinates. So now we have to relate r, theta, x and y. So what we will do? We will use trigonometry, like sine theta and cos theta rules. So there is a rule, so ka to, means this rule says sine equals opposite over hypotenuse and cos equals adjacent over hypotenuse and tan equals opposite over adjacent. So these are the rules of sine, cos and tan. We are going to use it here. So first we will use sine rule. So sine theta equals, you know, it's a right angle triangle. So opposite over hypotenuse. So y over r. That will give us y equals r sine theta. That's the first relation. And then use cos. Cos theta equals adjacent over hypotenuse. So x here, adjacent is x over r. That will give us x equals r cos theta. That's the second relation. Now we will use Pythagoras theorem for right angle triangle. R square equals x square plus y square. So that will give us r equals root x square plus y square. This is the third relation. Now we will find relation for theta also. So we will use tan here. You know, tan theta equals opposite over adjacent. What is the opposite? Y over x. So that will give us theta equals tan inverse y over x. That's the four relation. We got all the relation for x, y, r and theta. Whatever we have to change, we can use these relations to convert Cartesian into polar coordinates or polar coordinates into Cartesian coordinates. So first we are going to convert polar coordinates into Cartesian coordinates. Suppose a point is given which is polar coordinate 2 root 2 comma pi by 4. That means r equals 2 root 2 and theta equals pi by 4. You know pi equals 180 degree. So pi by 4 means 180 by 4, that means 45 degree. So angle is actually 45 degree. Now we have to convert this r comma theta into what? X comma y, because we are converting these polar coordinates into Cartesian coordinates. So we have to find the values of x and y. In the past slides, we have seen formula for x is r equals r cos theta and y equals r sin theta. We are going to use these two formulas. So x equals r cos theta. Plug in values of r and theta. R equals 2 root 2 and theta equals 45 degree. So that gave us x equals 2. Now y equals r sin theta. Then again plug in values of r and theta and that will give us y equals 2. So we got 2 comma 2 as Cartesian coordinate here. You can see also this is x 1 2. X equals 2 and 1 2. Y equals also 2. Now we are going to convert a Cartesian coordinates into polar coordinates. Suppose we have a point here and its Cartesian coordinates are 1, 2, 2 for x and 1, 2, 3. So 2, 3 are the Cartesian coordinates. Now we want to convert it into polar coordinates. That means r and theta. We have to find the values of r and theta here. So in the past slides, we have got the formulas for r and theta. R equals root x square plus y square and theta equals tan inverse y over x. So we are going to use these two formulas to find the values of r and theta. So r equals root x square plus y square. Plug in values of x and y here. Those are x equals 2 and y equals 3. That will give us r equals root 13. And you know theta equals tan inverse y over x. So plug in value of y and x, tan inverse. Value of y is 3. So 3 would be up by 2. Tan inverse 3 by 2. So that will give us 56.3 degree. So polar coordinates would be root 13 comma 56.3 degree. This is r and that's theta. I hope you understand this topic here. Don't forget to subscribe for daily updates. If you have any question, you can ask your question in comment box given below. Thank you.